Welcome back to the next session of Advanced Accounting for all year 2nd BCom Computers and General Students. Let us do the problem number 4. Problem number 3 under retirement of partner. So this is problem number 3. Stock depreciated means debit side. Two stock. Then P R D D. Two debtors. How much debtors value? 10,000. 10,000 into 5%. It comes to 500. Then next 980 provided for outstanding expenses. When the liability increases, debit side. Two outstanding expenses 980. So find the profit, credit side more 10,000. So two partners accounts. Add these three amounts 960, 500, 980. So distribute among the partners Rakesh, Suresh and Tarun in their ratio. So Rakesh 7560 into 4 by 9. Then Suresh 7560 into 3 by 9. Then Tarun 7560 into 2 by 9. So for Rakesh 3,360, for Suresh 2,520, and for Tarun 1,680. So this is about the revaluation account. Copy the revaluation account, then we will go for capital accounts. So after preparation of revaluation account, then next we have to prepare capital account for the three partners. So first capital account starts with by balance brought down. So by balance brought down with their capitals 40,000, 30,000 and 20,000. Then second step revaluation account. So by revaluation account, which we calculated profit in the revaluation account and distributed in the capital ratio. So for Rakesh 3,360, for Suresh 2,520 and for Tarun 1,680. Next reserve fund. If you observe the balance sheet, then we have reserve fund. Reserve fund is nothing but general reserve. Already I explained about the general reserve. So what we have to do when general reserve is given? We have to distribute among all the partners in their own ratio in case of retirement. Because for admission and retirement these will be differ. Like revaluation profit, then general reserve. In case of admission we used to give only old partners. But in case of retirement, we have to distribute among all the three partners, all the partners, including retiring partner also. So reserve fund is nothing but general reserve. So for Rakesh 8,000, Suresh 6,000 and Tarun 4,000. Now goodwill. So what is the total goodwill we have in the question? Total goodwill 21,600. So I'll write here. Goodwill of the firm. Calculation of goodwill of Suresh. So 21,600 is into what is Suresh? So once you calculate 9 ones are or 3 ones are 3 threes are 3 ones are 3 sevens are 21 3 twos are 6 so 7200 is the share of Suresh. So here the entry is Suresh account data to goodwill account. This is the entry. So by capital account under Suresh column 7200. After taking Suresh share, the same share we have to write out. Because once you check the last adjustment, what is given in the last adjustment? We have to write off the goodwill after Suresh retirement. So first what we have to do? We have to find the share of Suresh from the total goodwill, total company goodwill according to his share. So it is 7200. Now the same 7200 you have to divide among the Rakesh and Tarun in their new ratio. So what does this means? When we are taking on debit side, actually we have to take only on credit side, which one? Goodwill. But when we take both the sides, it means we are writing off the goodwill, written off means cancel, then it won't appear in the balance sheet. Okay, so the same 7200 will be divided in the 5:3 ratio, which is their new ratio of Rakesh and Tarun. So after posting all the adjustment, now find the balance total of Rakesh, that is 51,360. 51,360 minus 4,500. So this is the new capital of Rakesh. Then do for Suresh. So for debit side we don't have anything for Suresh. So the total is 45,720, which we have to transfer to loan account because he is a retiring partner. So whatever the amount due to the retiring partner, company will transfer to the loan account. Then Tarun, total 25,680 minus 2,700. This is the balance available. So what do you call this balance? It is nothing but new capital of Tarun. So this is about the capital account. Then come to the liabilities, balance sheet. New balance sheet of Suresh, Rakesh and Tarun. Now creditors as usual, because there is no change. Then capitals of Rakesh, which we calculated here, 46,860. Then Tarun, 22,980. Together, 69,840. Then Suresh loan. Why it is liability? Because the company has to pay to the Suresh. So 45,720. Then outstanding expenses, which increase. That means in the old balance sheet, we don't have any outstanding. But in the adjustment asked to provide. So outstanding liability increasing. That's why we are showing in the balance sheet 980. Then cash in hand as usual, cash at bank, no change as usual. Debtors 10,000 minus PRBD. Then stock also after depreciation. Plant and machinery no change. Then land and building after increase. If you do the total of liabilities and assets, you will get the amount 1,30,340. So this is about the problem number 3 for the retirement of partner. So please copy down. Please try to solve the homework problems which I had given, so that you will get an idea how to do the problem. retirement of partner. The next topic is death of a partner. So when any partner suddenly if expired, then what is the treatment of this account? How the amount will be paid to the deceased partner? Deceased partner means nothing but whose death happened. The partner who is no more in the company. So under death of a partner, so first the main point is calculation of deceased partner's share of profit. So remaining all are same. There are no change in the like general reserve, like revaluation account, then goodwill. But only the change is deceased partner's share of profit. So for their formulas, first average profit. I think you already learned this formula under cases of goodwill, methods of goodwill. So average profit, first we have to calculate to this formula, total profit by number of years. So after getting the average profit, then we should calculate deceased partner's share of profit. So what is the formula of average profit into number of days worked into his share divided by 365. Let us give a small example to explain this formula. For example, 3 years are given with the profits. Okay, 2010, 11, 12. So for each year, 50,000, 25,000 and 40,000. So what is the first step? Average profit. So find the average profit. 70,000. Okay, 70,000. How many years we have? 3 years. Or you take here 30,000.
Days. Here you can take either in the form of months or in the form of days, but depending on
1st December. So 9 months. He worked for 9 months in the company for this accounting year. So what we have to do according to this formula? Take the average profit 30,000 into 9. 9 by 12 into his share. Because always some share will be there for any partner. For example, his share 3 by 5. In this way, you have to take the formula. You have to substitute all the amounts in the formula. For example, if it is days, for example, accounting year 1st April 17 to 31st March 18. 15th May. If we expired on 15th May, so count from April to 15th May, how many days? April 30 days plus 15, 45 days. So 45 by 365. In this way you have to take, depends on the question. Whatever given in the question, according to that you have to substitute in the formula. I hope you understand this formula. Then remaining as usual. In the next video, we will do the problem. So please copy down the formulas which I have given regarding death of a partner.